I just think that the social media piece is very important for all of us. It's important because it is helpful. It is significant in this day of technology. However, it can be very detrimental if it is not handled properly.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And another thing that I wanted to add is, you know, I think that when I really think that somebody under the age of, I would say, 16, 17 is not even going to grasp the concept of representing who they are as a person, representing where they come from. And it's just like you said earlier, you know, one day your job can look at your Facebook from years ago and be like, I don't want you working for me because this is on your Facebook.
Absolutely.
And the problem is that at 12, 13 years old, which is now that I'm going to even say 10, because there are kids on Musical.ly, which is, you know, the little app where you can create little music videos and stuff, who are literally 10 years old. They get famous on that and they make Instagrams. So they're not even old enough to grasp the concept of not being in the now. They don't have the concept of really thinking about their future like that. I didn't really that concept didn't hit for me until it was ready for me to apply for colleges. That's when I actually had to start thinking like, okay, now I have to conduct myself in a way that people in the professional world would like to deal with me. And so, you know, personally, I'm not trying to be annoying, but I really think that this age of having all these 11, 12 year olds on social media at such a young age is really hurting them.
Yeah.
Because they're not even, it's one thing to protect your kids, but like they don't even have the concept. Some 12 year olds don't even know what sex is, much less posting in a post on Instagram and some random guy commenting under it, talking about all the nasty stuff he wants to do. They don't even get that yet. Like they're being exposed to things that come in life through social media. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, it becomes kind of hard to really explain how to really deal with your kids in that sense. Because personally, if I had a child right now, I don't know if I would let them be on social media that young, only because the things that they're exposed to on social media has no limit. You can't put parental controls on your Instagram. You can't put parental controls on Twitter, nor Snapchat, none of that. So it's like, aside from things that they're hiding, your kids are also being exposed to things that you don't even know that they're being exposed to.
Right. And see, that's my thing, because as parents, we have to have those conversations. Now, in my home when I was coming up, we were having those hard conversations. You know, you couldn't say that.
I want
to
do that.
No, man, I would like to be able to help with the outcome, if you will, you know. And so, yeah, and I don't want my child to experience unnecessary things. You know, I'm just,
this is not a dress rehearsal,
right?
This thing called life. You don't get another opportunity, and it unfortunately, or for the world, makes each generation grow up a little faster than we would like them to.
It's up high.
And we just kind of want to, you know, I was joking with you when you were talking about control. You do want it, but you do want some level of influence that you'd rather not have it wane, you know, especially when it comes to your children. You know, and some of these things, as Ambezi was saying, you can't throttle back, you know,
right.
You can't unring certain bells. You know, when you child comes to you and starts asking you questions, like, what is, and you're like, oh, blah, 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 you know, so, but the other thing, too, is what we end up doing sometimes as parents, and I have to be careful about this, and so not only social media, but other things, is we have to be careful not to project our experience on our kids.
Mm-hmm.
Because how we see things or how things may have happened for us may not be
right.
what they're experiencing. And sometimes experience is the best teacher, but in some of these cases in social media, you know, precisely because, you know, you could scar a child for life.
Right.
With some of this stuff, the internet could scar you for life. Mm-hmm. You know, I think of, you know, as we talk about a lot of the people who were, a lot of the shootings and all of this stuff that you know, we see and you're like, wow, where was, you know, how do we miss some of these things? But, sometimes you see stuff, but you can't really act on it.
Right.
Because it's not a time to kind of, it looks a little different, but it's not crossed the line yet. But you just want to be able, there's no easy way around. It's almost like losing weight. You know, we can talk about all the diets in the world, but at the end of the day, you know, eating less food and moving your body more is what makes the difference.
Absolutely.
So with this whole thing about what we've all been saying along the line is know your children, know your child, and get in there, you know, and parent. There's no other way around it. You can't not have the conversation and hope that the world is going to fix it so that you don't have to get in because you're uncomfortable doing this or doing that. Man, you know, you got to be willing to get in there and just parent. I mean, I don't think, as I was saying earlier, I don't think it changes, you know, because it's technology. You still have to parent and you still have to do what you have to do and you still have to have a relationship with your kids. And you know, if you find that there's something that they need a little more than what you can give them, you got to be able to give them that too.
Absolutely.
Give them access to that if they need that help.
Exactly. And speaking of technology, I had to do a quick mic repair, so I guess now I can join the conversation again.
Technical difficulties. All right. Well, this has been a great conversation, and we still have a few categories to cover, so let's take a quick break, and when we return, let's talk about having a conversation with your kid about your expectations of their social media activity. We will be right back.
You're listening to Straight No Chaser, the only show to quench your talk radio thirst.
Anyone else?
My name is David, and in 8 years, I'll be an alcoholic.
I did.
I'll start drinking in middle school, just at parties. But my parents won't start talking to me about it till high school. And by then, I'll already be in some trouble.
Kids who drink before age 15 are 5 times more likely to have alcohol problems when they're adults.
The thing is, my parents won't even see it coming.
So start talking.
Who's next?
Before they start drinking.
I just remembered it's election day. Are you going to vote?
I don't know. I don't think I'll have time today.
Millions of eligible voters in America never make it to the polls or even register to vote. When you don't vote, you're letting other people make decisions for you and pick the things your taxes will pay for. Voting is more than a civic duty. It gives you a voice about the priorities and the future of your community and our nation. Voting gives you a seat at the table.
She's missing class, and she's dropping her pom-poms. Nobody knows where she is, not even her mom. Everybody thought she was the all-American girl. So there goes the books, it's all about the score. There goes the doggy, life is such a bore. There goes the family, she's got a new friend. There goes the looks, this is the end. I guess she really was the all-American girl.
Pick up heroin and you'll throw away everything you love. Share your stories on Instagram with hashtag heroin.
You don't like watered down issues? Let us serve you the hard stuff. So come on, let's get back to Pastor C, MBZ, and the Chief.
All right, and we are back from the break. I hope you guys are enjoying our happy hour. We have been in discussion with whether or not parents or guardians should monitor their children's social media habits. And actually, while we were on the break, Pastor C raised the same question on his Facebook and got an interesting response. What did you discover, Pastor C?
Well, you know, MBZ and the crew, I asked the question on Facebook, should parents monitor their children's social media platforms, text messages, and different communication resources or sources? And everybody is chiming in, yes. But one of the individuals who left a comment said that you can monitor all you want. How many parents know how to find the hidden apps and the apps that are disguised to look like a calculator or other useful apps, but are communication sources? So I did not know that you can actually disguise an app so that people will not know what you are connected to when they see your phone. And see, I want to say this. It seems as if as parents, we are more reactive than we are proactive. It's like we're 10 steps behind this particular generation because we're not current with technology. And we become naive.
And honestly, it's only because as parents, honestly, even if you're a parent and you have an Instagram, you're not necessarily immersed in the culture that the younger users are immersed in. Mm-hmm. For example, when you use Instagram, your feed is based on your particular age groups. They're all about demographics. So your results on your Instagram feed are going to be based on your age, your gender, who's popular in your demographic, all that kind of stuff. So even if you're on Instagram, you're still not going to get the same experience that your child is getting. But hold on to your seats, all my co-hosts who have daughters, because guess what those calculator apps are?
What are they?
What is it?
They are actually vaults. They're not social media.
It's called what?
Hold on. Let's press those headphones closer to your ears, okay?
Yeah. All right.
So they are.
Are you writing this down, Chief? You writing it down?
I'm trying to catch up, man.
Now, see, I'm trying to serve you some tea. You're going to have to listen now. They are actually vaults to hold explicit photos and videos. And the calculator is really where you can type in the password for it.
Oh, wow.
So how do you guys, how are you guys taking that news?
Well, wait a minute. So it's called the vault?
No. It's not called the vault.
What's it called?
It's called calculator. Like, it looks like a calculator app.
It's called
app.
Calculator?
It looks like a but calculator acts, app.
But it acts, yeah, it acts as a, so it holds
vault,
like,
pictures.
So it holds like all these butt movies and pictures.
Yes. Initially, yes. So if you have any if you have any content that you don't want to have.
You know what? You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take these smartphones and we're going back to brick phones. How about those bag phones, you know? And we're going to make sure kids have flip phones.
Now, hold on one more before you guys.
I'm going back to CB radio.
Hold on. Before you guys comment any further, one more piece of information that's going to that's gonna rock your world, okay?
Oh my God.
So the creator of Snap.